Ready to start the second half of play here in Morgantown, West Virginia at Mountaineer Field, and a lot of the folks have gone to the parking lots to enjoy some refreshment, and we have been refreshed by the play of these two Heisman candidates. And as you mentioned, they've not really done anything to hurt their cause. I think maybe the thing that maybe surprises me a little bit, Slayton hasn't touched the ball as much as we maybe thought he would.
No, but the thing is, whatever works, and Patrick White has been a dominating factor out here this evening. You know, last six games last year, he averaged 100 yards. Patrick White, 100 yards rushing, 100 yards passing. And today he has 163 yards passing, 62 yards rushing at the halfway point. But Patrick White has really, really shown some skills. And, you know, Steve Slayton hasn't hurt himself with a couple of scores.
And Darius Raynaud will be deep for the Mountaineers to receive the second half kickoff. Out of the left-footed leg of Mike Jones. And that last drive that ate up about the last 5 minutes of the first half was very important to the Broncos. And they've got to feel much better about their situation. If they can keep from making the mistakes, getting the penalties and the turnovers, I'm sure they feel they can play as the shadows begin to creep across the brand new field turf that they have here. And we are underway. It is going to be a very short kick, taken at about the 23-yard line by Sowers. Sowers will get out to about the 37-yard line, and that's where the Mountaineers, who for the most part, except for that one possession, they've had pretty good field possession all afternoon.
They really have. And you know, it's interesting about Sowers. He's a converted quarterback. He's like a kamikaze kind of guy. He can play defense, special teams, whatever, and whatever it takes, he's out there. Number 12, Nate Sowers.
Spotted at the 38-yard line. They set up. Jala is in there. Raynaud is in there at the wide receiver spot. Steve Slayton is in the backfield. Schmidt is in the slot. He plays all over the place. There's the quick out, and the pass is caught by Raynaud. And he is spun down as he gets the 45-yard line. Tackle made by London Fryer. Well-known Father Irving Fryer. He's a defensive back, is London Fryer. Schmidt goes out. Sowers comes in. Of four wide outs in this formation for the Mountaineers. Slayton remains the lone running back. Second and three, a gain of 7 on the opening play of the second half. And I'm sure Rich Rodriguez would like to see his offense make a sustained drive and take it down the field. That's going to be good for a first down as he passes on the far side of the field. Making the catch is Darrell Jala. Austin Pritchard, number 35 there defensively.
First down, West Virginia.
But the Mountaineers will move the chains on their opening possession. They move it into Bronco territory, a gain of 8 on the last play. And of course, you give a lot of this credit to the speed of those two guys in the backfield, but if the holes aren't there from that offensive line, then it's not going to happen. And for the most part, the last couple of years, it has been. There's the quick pass to Raynaud, and he'll be dragged down. Mac, they went 6-2 in the Mac West last year, lost in the International Bowl to Cincinnati 27-24. They were the best defensive team in the Mac a year ago. Being tested by this West Virginia offense, and more passing downfield he goes. White just a little. Sowers is back in there. Slayton has been moved into the wide receiver spot. White looking to pass on third down, now running for his life. And again,
it was just too little too late.
It is the first punt, and it's not a good one. First punt of the afternoon goes out of bounds. The first time the Mountaineers have tried to punt all day, and Pat McAfee and his coach will not be happy about the results of that.
McAfee's got a pretty strong lead. He's got a 51-yard field goal against Pittsburgh to his credit, but you couldn't go by that last punt.
No, it was a 6-yard punt.
He could have punched it further than that.
They could have used Schmidt to quick kick.
That's right.
West is here. Is the running back. Simmons, Martin, Julian. Other wide outs. Hiller's performed very well. They had a great drive to end the first half. Hiller sets, looks, caught, but once again, West will be wrapped up right at the line of scrimmage. Magro was there. So Magro coming in to make the tackle defensively. He picked up maybe one. It'll be third down and about six, maybe five. 12:25 to play. We're in the third quarter.
Magro, an interesting number. He's 455-pound brand, 660 squat. You know, he can do 28 reps with 225 pounds, so he's got a little thump to him when he hits you.
Third down and long. Hiller waits. Now has to move away from the pressure and is hit and throws it downfield incomplete. It was intended for Ledbetter as he was falling out of bounds. Ivy was there on the coverage, but a good job by Hiller just to keep from being sacked.
Yeah, he got a lot of pressure into a bombs going off all around him. And, you know, he just, he was just trying to put out fires and was lucky it wasn't a turnover. And, you know, but he made the most out of that play.
Rivers will be deep for the Mountaineers. Laney will punt. So each team forced to punt on their first possession of the second half. Neither team has been able to score. We still have the same score as halftime. 28-14, number three, West Virginia. Michigan has already lost today to App State at home. Wow. And his kick is a good one. Fair catch called for and taken at the 15-yard line. So that's where the Mountaineers will set up in their second possession of the second half. A 42-yard punt. So West Virginia will have the football with 11:50 to play here in the third quarter. And I think the line was about 27, 28 points. And maybe there are some people thought the Mountaineers would come out here and run over Western Michigan, but that has not been the case.
Well, there was some, you know, it showed some spurts with West Virginia, what they can do with Slayton and White, and put up some numbers. But Western Michigan came back roaring again with that big drive at the end of the second quarter and made it more of a game, just 14-point deficit.
And Schmidt is now one of the wide receivers, the inside handoff to Slayton, and he's wrestled down after a gain of about a yard. Not much there. Wrapped up by Austin Pritchard, one of the linebackers making the tackle.
But he's been kind of silent. You haven't seen the exciting runs out of Slayton that you've seen in the past.
Now Slayton is now a wide receiver in this five wide receiver formation on second down and eight. Makes the catch. 20, 25. Tried to step away from a tackle, and he goes down at about the 37-yard line. Gebhardt made the hit. Slayton picks up 11 and a first down for West Virginia.
You know, it's a nice little pitch and catch by White and Slayton, and also you can't see number 70. Good block right there on the edge, but number 70, Rodemeyer, is downfield, a 6'4", 300-pound redshirt freshman blocking downfield, just evidenced by how that offensive line runs so well.
Owen Schmidt moves back into the backfield now as the fullback. Straight ahead handoff and some running room, about 8, maybe 9 yards. Pritchard again made the tackle, but Owen Schmidt, I think that's what, his second carry of the game? He made 8 yards on the play.
Well, Owen Schmidt is a strength All-American, and he's just a throwback. He's busted 8 face masks. You know, he could have played, he's kind of a Mike Allstadt a little bit, John, but he could have played in the 50s or 60s, and really he's blood and thunder kind of guy. And you can see good blocking up front, everybody hitting their man, and Owen Schmidt just leaving a hole, an option for him, and it's one-on-one with Schmidt. He's going to win every time.
Nice pick up on the play. Good quick move for a first down on the sweep that time by Steve Slayton. He'll get 5 more. And the Mountaineers will move the chains. Corey Flom, the nose guard, made the tackle for Western Michigan. The Broncos down by 2 touchdowns.
First down, West Virginia.
And here they go. They call it the Jet. Schmidt, Slayton, Jala, Gonzalez, Reynaud, all in there at the same time. Schmidt lines up in the more normal fullback position in the I formation. They have so many options. Here's the handoff. Room up the middle for Slayton. Goodbye. He is gone. You're not going to catch Slayton. 5 touchdowns.
Steve Slayton.
A burst up the middle. When he got about 5 yards past the line of scrimmage, Renee, you knew they were not going to catch him.
He's running downhill, and with that 4.36 speed, he puts separation for the defensive backs. Also credit outstanding blocking up front. And that triple option. Look, that hole, John, you and I could have run through it. And Steve Slayton just running away from the competition. No one's going to catch him. It's third score of the game. And, boy, I tell you what, they just keep coming at you with everything they have.
Now they up with the lead now to 35-14. And did you notice at the finish of that run that he moved the ball into his right arm, which he couldn't do last year, and took it in for the touchdown with that nicely repaired wrist. So he's healthy, that's for sure. A 58-yard touchdown run. Slayton for the Mountaineers breaks loose. 35-14, still 9:54 left in the third quarter.
I'm not real sure. I know we never had a quarterback as fast as Pat White.
Obviously not. All right, back to action. The kickoff, the Mountaineers have just scored touchdown number 5. Coach, we'll get you a chair here.
Okay.
Appreciate you stopping by, getting off the golf course.
Yeah.
Now the Mountaineers coaches have gotten the job done. They haven't. That was a great play. They just ran right there up the middle, and that's where Slayton gets the chance to show his speed and what he can do.
Yeah, well, that's an inside zone play, John, and you know everybody leads to their right, and when that seam opens up, he's got the speed to break it right through there.
First down and 10 at the 20-yard line for the Broncos. And Don, they had a nice drive, did Western Michigan, right before halftime, kind of got themselves back in the ballgame.
Western Michigan's a pesky bunch, I'll tell you that. But basic set is a three-man line, and it's hard to rush the passer with just three guys. They're doing more blitzing now. They were going to do
11th penalty on the Broncos, sets them back to a second and long. They go from the shotgun. Hiller looking, has time. Throws, that's going to be intercepted. He overthrew the receiver. It's picked off by Reed Williams, and Williams gets down close to the 20-yard line. The second interception, third turnover of the ball game for the Broncos.
And you had a middle linebacker dropping deep on that zone coverage and did an outstanding job coming with an interception, Reed Williams. And Coach, you know, the thing is, we talked earlier about the recruiting, and you just touched on it. Coach Rodriguez did such a great job recruiting in Pennsylvania and Florida, and he's rewarded the walk-ons. 26 walk-ons have gotten scholarships in the last 5 years, and he's got a good blend of blue-collar guys and superstars.
No question about it. They've done a great job recruiting. The big thing they've been able to recruit is speed. They got a lot of kids on this program that can run.
They even have a couple kids we haven't seen much of this afternoon, a couple freshmen who can fly.
Right.
And Devine and Sanders.
They're both really quick kids. I've watched them in practice.
Some pressure, but all alone, and it's going to be overthrown. I think maybe the pressure that was coming up the middle that time, Slayton was the intended receiver, but they got good pressure up the middle, and White had to unload before he wanted to.
On that play, John, they isolate Slayton on an inside linebacker, and that's a mismatch.
Yeah, it is.
There's no way on the.
I'm sure there's anybody in the white jersey that's not a mismatch for Slayton at times.
Yeah, exactly. And you're right. Pat had somebody in his face, or he'd have got him the ball.
It'll be second down and 10. The ball is at the 22-yard line following the interception. Mountaineers trying to open it up now here in the third quarter. White on the run. Steps through. There 10, 5. See ya. Well, Don, there are two Heisman Trophy candidates down there on the field, and they are doing nothing to disappoint with the way they're playing this afternoon.
Oh, you're not kidding. I'm not sure it's good to have two on the same team, because I got a feeling that could hurt you, but those two kids are both really good football players. And you know, not only are they good football players, they're good citizens, they're good guys.
You know, he showed a lot of patience in this right now, waiting for his block. A lot of guys, and I know, Coach, when you coached here, you know, young freshmen get here and guys, and they just want to get out and run, and they have to learn to be patient, read the blocks and stuff. And Pat White has really become an exceptional runner, and he's shown he can pass the ball as well.
Oh, yeah. I'll tell you right now, I watch him in practice. He can throw the football big time.
All right, we're going to take a break right now, Don. You stick around. We'll be with you when we come back. The Mountaineers have opened it up 42-14, 8:39 to play. The offensive explosion of the tandem of White and Slayton continues. Mountaineers in control. They'll be kicking off again. And Don Nealon is still here, former head coach of the Mountaineers, who's still enjoying things in Morgantown. How are you occupying your time now, Coach?
Well, you know, John, I'm the spokesman for the West Virginia Coal Association, and I have a lecture series at the university. And last fall, I even taught a class. And I play a little golf, and there's a construction company down in Bridgeport that I kind of monkey around with at times, and I just seem to have plenty to do.
Isn't there a little golf course down in Bridgeport, too?
They might build one, another one.
What if the Pete Dye Club? You don't go there, do you?
Oh, yeah, I go there.
All right, the kickoff is on its way. Brandon West will handle it to five. He's got good speed, got a little room. West will get outside the 30, close to the 35-yard line before he's wrestled down. Well, I know you've seen a lot of changes. This is the 28th year for this excellent facility, but they built the suites down at that one end, closing up an area that used to have bleachers there. They lost a few seats in the process, but I think what they've got here is a 60,000-seat stadium that's perfect for them.
Oh, there's no question. And this touchdown terrace, you know, it's almost like being there with the Pittsburgh Steelers, and, you know, they're going to put more boxes here in, in front of the weight room.
23 touchdown drives. You see, they can score in a hurry. They're also going to redo the weight rooms and the locker rooms after the season is over. That's down at the other end of Mountaineer Field.
But they had Pennington and Moss then.
That's exactly right.
They don't have Pennington and Moss now.
I know. Don, thanks again.
Yep. We'll see you.
We appreciate it. Take care.
Right.
Thank you, Coach.
Don Nealon, longtime coach of the Mountaineers of West Virginia, very successful coach, a guy that really built this program up. Had success with the bowl games, played twice for the national championship.
And a jewel in the coaching ranks.
Absolutely.
A jewel in the coaching ranks.
I tell you, though, he looks more relaxed now than he did then.
Oh, well, he did a great job, and he set the standard. I'd say he set the bar pretty high in the coaching ranks.
Perrigan is the quarterback. Thompson the running back. Perrigan throws. Catch is made right. First down 10. Again, Thompson the lone setback. And getting outside again is Jamarco Simmons.
Perrigan's pass complete.
So Perrigan going to Simmons.
Flag on the play.
There's a flag on the play. 11 catches.
Number 41 on the defense.
And the 15-yard dead ball foul is called on West Virginia's Eric Wicks, one of the returning veterans out of Perry High School in Pittsburgh. And by the way, the other defender, Ryan Mundy, who came from Michigan, Michigan shockingly losing today, is also from Pittsburgh. And part of the reason he came here is to get closer to home.
Yeah, and you know, he's going to be a great addition, Mundy is, to this defense. 6'1", 205, big physical hitter. You know, something about Perrigan here. He's a pure passer, played in a run-oriented JUCO, but he's got a stronger arm than Hiller, and I think you can look for him to air it out quite a bit.
And he once again goes to his favorite receiver, Jamarco Simmons, with his 12th catch. But that's a no-gainer right there, or a very little gain on the play. Holmes and Williams teamed up defensively. Gain of three on the play.
Think about Perrigan. In 2006, he led the Broncos in wins over Toledo and Virginia. So he's tasted success here with Western Michigan.
He is having a great afternoon. There's still plenty of time to go. We just passed the midway point. Once again, it's West. Now, I'm John Sanders along with Renee Nadeau, and that time Perrigan is going to pick up the first down himself. Johnny Holmes makes the tackle. He picks up three, six.
Unbelievable.
And you get two large people to carry you around, I guess. Perrigan going to be hit from behind and dropped. Dropped on the play. He took the hit.
Perrigan, sack on the
play. Glover was right there. Loss of three on that sack. Moves the ball back outside the 25 to the 26-yard line.
And the thing is, the Mountaineers only recorded 9 sacks all the year. 9 sacks, since they're off to a pretty good start. Good pressure on the quarterback here. And Glover did a good job with the pressure and keeping Perrigan inside the box.
But as Don Nealon said, if you play a three-man front a lot of the time, you're not going to make that many sacks because you don't have enough bodies. If they will show blitz, and they're coming here. Thrown away, incomplete. Richardson was there, and Slavonic was applying the pressure as he came right up the middle. He's going to come out now. So it is fourth down play. Not much the Broncos can do at this point when you trail by 28, except go for it.
Well, he's lucky that last pass was not intercepted. The closest one to it was cornerback Kent Richardson in a blue jersey, so they live to fight. It's third down.
It is third down. I was thinking it was fourth down. It's third down. They're 4 of 11 on third down plays. They will go out of the shotgun. Thomas Perrigan running the offense. That is under. Pugh fell down on the play. That's why he was so wide open. Kerrigan under the gun from Mike Jones. The extra point attempt. This one is up.
You know, with 42 points and 5 minutes and 14 seconds to go in the third stanza, John, is wow, and they still have a lot of gas in the tank.
This is Raynaud who'll have it. Comes straight up the middle. He's got some room. Raynaud with a one quick move gets to the 50. Duclo made the tackle, but Raynaud showing his speed with a good punt, kickoff return, and he gives good field position. A 37-yard kick return.
He has tremendous explosion. We talk about the trio of Pat White, Slayton, and Raynaud. Raynaud negotiates to 40 and 4.46. Has a 41-inch vertical and has a team-high 695 squat. Tremendous explosion and body control. Raynaud, he may find him playing the next level on Sundays next year.
Well, the man that he really deked on the play was the kicker, so that doesn't count, right?
Oh, good blocking on special teams, you're right, but it's still a body, and he got through the hole and
yeah,
was
he got
broken.
Through it big time. Slayton squeezes for a couple down to about the 46-yard line, maybe the 47, 3-yard pickup. But he broke the big one. And White has done his part. These two have been very productive. We'll be showing you some graphics later to show the combination of offense that they've been able to produce. It'll be second down and 7.
The offensive line has done a great job, John, this afternoon, and can kind of control that line of scrimmage over the Bronco defense, and really did a good job. You know, we'll talk about how you really have to be a blue-collar guy to play offensive line anywhere, and no one does it better than West Virginia.
Slayton as a wide receiver. Schmidt stays in as the fullback to block, and White is in trouble. Throws short. Boy, that guy was all alone. If he'd had a little more time to straighten up, he'd have been able to get to Tito Gonzalez because he was alone over there because the defenders came up when it looked like White was going to run the football.
And White improvised a little bit, bought some time, broke the contain and got on the outside. He maybe could have ran, but he saw Tito Gonzalez open and hoping to complete a long pass. But you see, just buying time, and this is just patience, not throwing the ball too soon, just improvising, moving around. He's a tough target to hit. And maybe another 3 or 4 yards on that toss had been complete.
Raynaud, Gonzalez, Jala, the wideouts. Schmidt is the fullback. Slayton has gone all the way at tailback. Here comes the blitz. And he gets away from it. Up the middle, 40. Dragged from behind, stays on his feet, gets inside the 35. Pritchard finally made the tackle. Boy, they had the pressure coming on the blitz that time, and White beat it. 16-yard pickup for the West Virginia quarterback.
That's the mark of a mature quarterback. He doesn't panic. He sees the blitz coming and just finds a crease. Good broken field running here, and he breaks this tackle. He may take it to the house. There was no one between him and the end zone.
But they were finally able to drag him down, and as Pritchard did, grab him by the shoulder pads. The ball is at the 35-yard line. It's first down and 10, 3:50 remaining. And look at these numbers. 197 total. He's accounted for 4 touchdowns. Again, the blitz. There's the throw. There's the incomplete pass intended for Schmidt. And that was not an easy pass to catch. A little bit behind him, a little bit high, and Schmidt could not hang on.
And he can be, you know, a number of positions at the next level, tight end, fullback, whatever it may be, and he usually catches the ball, and that is a very tough catch to make. 6'3", 260-pound Owen Schmidt may be a tight end H-back in the NFL and negotiates to 40 and a 4.57. That's unbelievable. We mentioned he's a strength All-American, and, you know, he's got a cult following down here, has a sports of Mohawk under that helmet, and, you know,
he's got a great following.
Yeah.
You go outside, you'll see jerseys number 5 and 10 all over the place with a bunch of 35s mixed in there as well. A pass. No. And
Jock
we
Sanders,
expected
yeah.
to. 5 wideouts on 3rd down and 10. Ball at the 35-yard line of the Broncos. Again, the blitz. There's the pass incomplete. And that's going to be pass interference. The fans were calling for it before the flag hit the ground.
Well, he ran a seam route, and Slayton was going to beat the defensive back. He just reached out and grabbed him, and I guess it's better to get a penalty, and you live to fight another day. If he gives up that play, it's another touchdown, and Slayton had beaten him.
Now there's yellow all over this end of the field, which is now basically in the shadows.
Pass interference, number 21 on the defense. 15-yard penalty from the previous spot. First down.
Antoine Allen is the guilty party, number 21. And I tell you, in his defense, you try to stay with Steve Slayton, that's a tough task.
Coach Cubitt will not get mad at a play like that, because if anything, if you let him go, he'd yell at you. But, you know, if he holds on to him, at least he has a chance to fight another day. And Slayton, if not, we're kicking an extra point.
Now, 12th penalty on the Broncos, 87 total yards. The ball is spotted at the 19. Schmidt moves to a wide receiver in this formation. Got him in the slot on the right side. Four wide outs. Slayton in the backfield with White. There's the inside handoff, and Slayton leads inside the 15 down to maybe the 14-yard line before he's dropped by Allen. Well, Pat White, when he gets in this part of the field, is pretty darn good. 29 out of 46 for touchdowns. You add that there, and it's going to be 43 times out of 46. You get some kind of point out of it, and that's very good.
Yeah, well, you know, and he's scoring touchdowns, not field goals, and that's the thing. When you get in a red zone, you want to get the maximum, and he does quite that. And boy, I tell you, he's a complete quarterback.
Second down and 5. Same formation. Same play. Slayton's got room. 5. Dragged down at the 1-yard line. Gebhardt was able to get him before he got to the end zone, but it looked like he was heading that way for another touchdown.
He's got that afterburner, another gear, and Slayton just explodes when he gets to the second level. You see right here, getting an inside handoff.
First and goal.
And good vision, good cut right there off the block, and leaves a defender grabbing for air, and gets down at the 1-yard line. Good tackle, but he's got tremendous explosion. Gets to the second level so quickly.
Schmidt is in the normal fullback position in the eye. The blocking back in front of Slayton. Guess who has the ball? Slayton trying to sneak in, go underneath, and he could not get there. No gain. Gebhardt makes the hit. Anthony Gebhardt's playing pretty good here in the second half for the Western Michigan Broncos out of Kalamazoo.
Slate with 15 totes for 101 yards, and Patrick White 9 for 97. What a
hey, that's happened double, many times, hasn't it?
Double dose of dynamite, John.
It's fun to watch him. Again, Schmidt is the fullback. Second and goal. No problem. Slayton's into the end zone again. So Slayton scores again. Mountaineers move it out to 48-21.
Great block from Owen Schmidt. They try to come over the top, but he opens that hole. And again, great blocking, good surge on the offensive line. And Dent and company from the center position did a great job of giving him a crease to get him to the end zone.
It's good to give credit, though, to Owen Schmidt, because he was not going to let them close that hole.
No. He blocks like an offensive lineman.
Less than 2 remaining third quarter. Slayton is on the board. It's 49-21 with a minute and 59 to play in the third quarter. Look at that blocking up front.
Good block, and the damage is already done once he got the ball and nose for the end zone. You see Slayton again scoring. Ishmit, good surge on the offensive line. Great camera work right there, and Slayton with his third touchdown. Wow. And you know, his Patrick White and Slayton are roommates, but when Slayton went to the Playboy All-American shooting, he roomed with Darren McFadden. It's kind of interesting. Boy, what kind of talent they had in that room?
Well, that's the 4th touchdown for Slayton. He's got 24 points himself.
Yeah.
More than the Broncos as a team. But, you know, we expected to see this kind of an offensive show, and we're seeing it.
You know, they have they're in mid-season form, and to be this good this early in the season. And, you know, Western Michigan, again, could be the chalk of the MAC.
And, that's right.
So they're doing it against a pretty good team.
And we mentioned when we had Don Nealon up here that the next game will be at Marshall for West Virginia. The Friends of Cole Bowl will be played down there. And Joe Manchin, who is the governor, will join us in the fourth quarter, but he's been the instrumental in setting up that rivalry between Marshall and West Virginia on a regular basis. Next up for the Broncos of Kalamazoo, they'll be at home next Saturday to Indiana. Then they play at Missouri. So that is not an early season schedule is what I'm trying to say for Western Michigan.
Mountaineers 5-1 when White and Slayton exceed the 100-yard mark. and have done that this evening.
Brandon West will be the deep man for the Broncos. McAfee will kick off. At the 1 yard line. Ridden down hard and a flag comes in. That was Glover who made the hit on the special teams, but we also have a flag on the play.
Flag on play.
23-yard return. Got it out across the 20 to the 24. And we're still checking the flag.
On the return. Number 23. Holding. 10-yard penalty from the spot of the foul.
Nick Sadd is the guilty party there, picking up the penalty on the holding call, and that's kind of been the story of this afternoon from time to time. They'll do something good and then get a penalty or get themselves shot in the foot.
Well, you know, and I guess there aren't those things out, but those are the kind of things you do not want to have against a team such as West Virginia. They'll make it pay for it.
Well, 16 rushes, 109 yards for Steve Slayton. What new? 19 games he's played, and he's rushed for 100 yards or more in 16 of those games. We still have a minute 53 remaining here in the third quarter. Thompson will be the running back. Perrigan, who is playing the second half, Perrigan will be the quarterback. Two wideout formation, Martin and Jamarco Simmons. And that's straight ahead running that time by Thompson. And this will
guy for the Florida Gators, signed with Florida, left the Gators and went to a junior college and came headed to West Virginia.
They're going to nail him for another.
Be a great future here for the Mountaineers.
Berrigan with a quick handoff. Thompson will get a couple yards back, and that's about it.
Thompson.
Slavonic and Murrow, a couple of those down linemen make the tackle for the West Virginia. And some of the second team players are seeing some action now for the young men from Morgantown. 49-21, they've got the lead. Von Rivers will be deep to receive the punt. And you can see the shadows creeping ever farther across the field here in Morgantown.
Just hit a shot at Murrow. Thor Murrow, his dad, played for West Virginia, also played 9 years for the Atlanta Falcons, but his dad still holds the record with 15 tackles for losses in 1973. That record still stands. His dad, Jeff Murrow.
Well, we will head to the fourth quarter. Governor of the fine state of West Virginia, Joe Manchin, will join us. He'll talk about that Friends of Cole Bowl and more. It's 49-21. White, Slayton doing their thing for the Mountaineers. Stay with us.